Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, I am going to explain few more problems on equilibrium of forces. Here we have sixth problem. The problem is like this. A spear weighing 100 Newton is lifted in a right angled notch as shown in the figure. If all the contact surfaces are smooth, determine the reaction at contact surface. Before starting this problem, I want to explain basic concept related to cable and spear. In previous video, we solved few problems on cables. In that, if we have one cable like this, maybe AB, if it is connected at these points. So if I pull that cable, if I apply one load or one more load here, if I pull it downward, the reaction in string, maybe I will take OA, it is trying to pull that cable in this direction. But we were concentrating on the reaction, we used to take reaction in the opposite direction. So while drawing the free body diagram, it's supposed to be like this. If I pull this cable in this direction, I was concentrating on the reaction. My reaction at A or free body diagram at A will be like this. In cable, I explained action and reaction concept. If I am talking about spear, if I have one spear like this, if it is placed on contact surface A, so because of weight of this spear, maybe 100 kg, it is acting downward. If the system is in equilibrium, so this is action, whatever 100 kg, it is acting downward. This is the action from the spear. So at the same time, in the contact surface, one reaction is going to generate. It is in the opposite direction. So I can take this as reaction. So if the system is in equilibrium, if it is 100 kg acting downward, reaction will be 100 kg in the opposite direction. If I do the summation sigma Fy, that is 100 kg acting downward minus 100 kg acting upward plus, so ultimately it will be is equal to 0. That means this system is in equilibrium. So same way, this concept we have to apply on the spheres, then we have to find the reaction. So in this case, they given one sphere, it weighs 100 Newton. So now if I take this as contact surface A, then one more contact surface B. So if I am drawing the free body diagram for this figure, so I will take this sphere, I will denote it as O. So I will take this point O. So free body diagram, I will take free body diagram at O. So from this point O, first I am going to take whatever the weight is acting. Weight is always acting vertically downward. So I will take 100 Newton acting downward. Now because of this force, this 100 Newton is acting downward, it will be exerted on these points also. These are the action. So from contact surface A, one reaction is developed in the opposite direction. So I can take this as RA. At the same time, at contact surface B, one reaction is going to develop. I will take this as RB. So if I apply here like this, I can't apply the Lamy's theorem. It is very difficult to apply the Lamy's theorem. I want angle between forces. Okay. So in that case, what I will do is, instead of applying RA here, I will shift that in the line of action of that force, that is here. Then I will draw that RA here. So instead of taking RA here, I will take that RA at this point, that is RA. At the same time, whatever RB, I will shift in the line of action of force in this direction. Then I will draw here, that is RB. So after drawing this reaction, in this case only two contact surface, so two reaction. Now I have to find the angle. So if I have one triangle like this, so this is 30 degree. So from O, this reaction is coming. So if any circle is going to touch any tangent, if I draw the radius, that is 90 degree. So if this is 90 degree, if I continue, if I complete that figure, this is 90 degree, then this is 30 degree. Total angle of the triangle is 180 degree. Therefore, remaining is 60 degree. Therefore, this RB is going to incline at an angle of 60 degree with the horizontal. This will be 60 degree. So I will explain again for the other contact surface, that is A. So if I take point A like this, okay, this is 60 degree. Here this 60 degree. So then one circle is touching that point, that is here. So this contact surface, it is connected to the center. This will be radius, this is 90 degree. Same thing I will draw till here, therefore this is 90 degree. Now if I consider this triangle, so total angle of the triangle is 180 degree. This is 60 degree, this is 90 degree. Therefore remaining is 30 degree. Therefore if this is RA, which makes 30 degree with the horizontal, same thing I want to draw here, that is 30 degree. So once I get these angles, now I can apply the Lamy's theorem. To apply the Lamy's theorem, I want to find angle between other two forces. Now, if I want to find angle between other two forces, I know that this is 90 degree, this will be 90 degree. Therefore, this is 60 plus 90, that will be 150 degree. Same way, this angle, that is 30 plus 90, that will be 120 degree. So remaining here, so total straight line is having 180 degree. From that I have to deduct 60 and 30. So 180 minus 60 minus 30, this will be 90 degree. But in the question also they given, that is right angle notch, therefore it is having 90 degree. After finding the angle, I can apply the Lamy's theorem on this point. So I will apply Lamy's theorem. Force, that is 100 Newton divided by sine of the angle between other two forces. For this 100 Newton, other two forces RB and RA. So between that, that is 90 degree. That is equal to, I will take one more force, that is RA. For that other two forces RB and 100 Newton, angle between them, that is 150 degree. So therefore RA divided by sine 150 degree. The last force, that is RB, the other two forces for RB is 100 Newton and RA. So angle between them is 120 degree. Therefore sine 120 degree. So I applied Lamy's theorem. Now I will consider first two equation. So I want to find reaction RA. Therefore 100 into sine 150 divided by sine 90. So if I do the calculation, I'm going to get, that is 50 Newton. Now I'm going to consider other two equation, that is first and third equation. In that I want to calculate RB. Therefore 100 into sine 120 divided by sine 90. So we will get 86.60 Newton. So here we have our seventh problem in equilibrium of forces. Find the reaction from the inclined plane and tension in the string or cable is also known as string. For the arrangement as shown in the figure, take weight of the ball as 450 Newton. So this problem is the combination of cable and sphere. So I'm going to draw the free body diagram at O. So first I will take that point O. I will draw the weight of the sphere that is always acting downward in vertical direction, that is 450 Newton. They given in the question. So after that I will consider that cable. So if I see that cable action, it is trying to pull that cable in the downward direction. So from the beginning of this concept, I'm telling our concentration is on the reaction in the opposite direction. So just I will explain again, it is trying to pull that cable in the downward direction. Our concentration on the reaction, it is in the opposite direction. So reaction is always in the opposite direction of the action. So therefore our reaction in this direction, so I will take that reaction, maybe this point I will take as A, then this point I will take as B. I will denote it as B. Therefore reaction in this cable I will take TOA, that is tension OA. Now it is going to rest, that sphere is going to rest on point B. So because of weight of that sphere, the action will be like this. Therefore from the support, from the contact surface, the reaction in the opposite direction, that is towards the center of the sphere. So if I apply here like this, I can't apply Lamy's theorem. So I will shift in the line of action, then I'm going to draw here. Because this is reaction, I will take this as RB. After finding the reaction and tensions in the cable, now I have to find the angle. They given this is 30 degree, so circle is going to touch maybe at this point, that point B. So to the center, this is O, this is radius, therefore this makes an angle 90 degree. Always radius makes an angle 90 degree with the tangent, therefore this is 90 degree, therefore this is 60 degree, because total angle of the triangle is 60 degree. Therefore this reaction, whatever we drawn, that is RB, will makes an angle 60 degree with the horizontal. Therefore I can take this as 60 degree. Now angle of the string TAO or tension OA, so if I take this, if two parallel lines, one line is going to cut those parallel lines. If this is 70 degree, I can take this as 70 degree. These are alternate angles. So I can take this as 70 degree. After considering the angle, I have to calculate the angle between two forces. So this angle I can calculate like total angle of this right line is 180 degree. From that I have to deduct 60 and 70. This angle is 50 degree. So total angle here, so that is, I know that this is 90 degree, this is 90 degree, therefore 90 plus 60, that is 150 degree. The last angle this one, so 70 plus 90, that is 160 degree. Now I'm going to apply Lamy's theorem. First I will take 450. For that angle between other two forces, are TOA and RB, that is 50 degree, therefore sine 50. That is equal to, so I considered this now. Now I'm going to consider RB divided by, for this force, other two forces TOA and 450 Newton. So angle between other two forces, that is 160 degree, therefore sine 160. That is equal to the last force that remaining, that is TOA, for these other two forces RB and 450 Newton. Angle between them, that is 150 degree, therefore sine 150 degree. Now I'm going to consider equation 1 and equation 2. From that, RB is equal to 450 into sine 160 divided by sine 50. So if I do the calculation, I will get 200.91, that is Newton as the force. Now I'm going to consider first and third equation. In that, I want tension in OA, that is TOA, that is equal to 450 into sine 150 divided by sine 50. So we will get 293.72 Newton. Here we have our eighth problem on equilibrium of forces. A container with inner clearance of 100 mm carries two spheres of radius 350 mm and 250 mm as shown in the figure. The weights are 600 Newton and 500 Newton respectively. That means 350 mm sphere is having 600 Newton and 250 mm sphere is having 500 Newton. So they ask, find the reactions at all the points of contact. So before starting this problem, we have to find some angles. So for that, I'm going to draw this figure again. They given radius of this sphere. So that means if this is radius, so I can take this as 350, then this as 250 mm, then this distance will be 350 plus 250, 600 mm. So I can draw the triangle now. Therefore, this distance, how we can calculate, that is 1000 minus 350 minus 250, that is equal to 400 mm. So by using this, I will draw this, that is 400 mm. Hypotenuse side is 600 mm. Now I can calculate this theta. So that is adjacent and hypotenuse. So I will take cos theta. Cos theta is equal to 400 divided by 600. Therefore theta is equal to 48.18 degree. So after this, I want to draw the free body diagram. So I will take here, this is M and N. So if I consider point N, so I will take free body diagram at N. So weight of the N. So second sphere, the weight is given, that is 500 Newton. So that is always acting downward, that is 500 Newton. So after that, so if I check, it is going to touch the point D and C. Therefore, one reaction is coming from D. So as we discussing, this will be the action because of that force towards the support, reaction in the opposite direction. This will be the reaction from these contact surfaces. Whatever the reaction coming from D, so I will shift in the line of action, then I'm going to draw here. So I will take this as R D. Same way, one reaction is coming from C, I will shift in the line of action, I'm going to draw here. I will take this as R C, because this is vertical, therefore this is 90 degree, therefore whatever the reaction will makes an angle, that is RD, is 90 degree. So RC, so that is theta, because here it is theta, same line of action is going to continue, therefore here this also theta, therefore I will take this as theta. So theta we already calculated, that is 48.18 degree. So after calculating this, now I can apply the Lami's theorem. So to apply that Lami's theorem, I have to find the angle between two forces, that is each force I have to find the angle. First angle I'm going to calculate, that is this one. So 90, this will be 90 degree, therefore 90 plus 48.18, that is 138.18 degree. So this angle I can calculate. Total angle of the straight line is 180 degree. So 180 degree minus 48.18, so I will get, so that is 131.82 degree. So remaining we already know that will be 90 degree, because this will be, if I consider one circle like this, one vertical surface radius is going to makes an angle 90 degree with the tangent. So after finding all the angle and reactions, now I'm going to apply Lami's theorem. So first I'm going to consider known force, that is 500 Newton. So other two forces, RC and RD, I angle between them is 131.82 degree, therefore sine 131.82 degree. This is equal to second force I'm going to consider, RC. For RC, other two forces are RD and 500 newton, angle between them is 90 degree, therefore sine 90 degree. This is equal to the third force remaining, that is RD. So other two forces for RD is 500 Newton and RC is 138.18 degree, therefore sine 138.18 degree. Now I'm going to consider equation number 1 and equation number 2. RC is equal to 500 into sine 90 divided by sine 131.82 degree. If I do the calculation, I am going to get 500 into sine 90 divided by sine 131.82, that is 670.92 newton, because in the question they given weight are Newton, though this value also Newton. Now, after this, I'm going to consider second and third equation. So, in that RD is equal to 500 into sine 138.18 degree divided by sine 131.82 degree. So if I do the calculation, we will get 447.36 Newton. So this is the point N, that is sphere N. Now I'm going to consider one more sphere, that is M. So I will take free body diagram at M. So I'm considering point M. So first, weight of the M. So for larger sphere, they given 600 Newton. 350 radius sphere is having 600 Newton. Always weight is acting downward. I will take like this 600 Newton. After that, I have to check how many contact surfaces for M. In this case, we have three contact surface. One is C, action is away from the point. So one more is B, action is away from the point. Then A, towards that A. Now reaction from C towards the center of the sphere. So from C it is acting like this. In the line of action I can shift. So from C I can take R C. At the same time, one reaction is coming from B. I can shift in the same line of action. Then I can draw like this, that is R B. Because reaction from B, I will take that as R B. Then one more reaction is coming from A towards the center of the sphere. I can shift the in the line of action. Then I can draw it as R A. So total three contact surfaces, three reaction, that is R A, R B and R C. Now angle I have to find. If I see in the figure R B, if I join this point, this will be 90 degree. Therefore R B will makes an angle 90 degree with the horizontal. If I see that RA, this contact surface is vertical, reaction is in horizontal direction, so RA makes an angle 90 degree with the vertical, or it is acting exactly horizontal. Now remaining is RC. If I see in the figure, we already calculated this is theta. Therefore opposite angle, this will be theta. So that theta is 48.18 degree. In the previous step, we calculated. If this is theta, opposite angle will be theta. Don't get confused. This is not theta. The opposite angle. If two straight line is like this, if this is theta, this will be theta. After doing this calculations of angle, if you have three forces and three angles, I can apply the Lamy's theorem. But in this case, we have four forces. Therefore, limitation of Lamy's theorem is you can apply only for three forces. Therefore, I have to apply the equilibrium condition to solve this point M. So equilibrium conditions are summation of horizontal forces is equal to zero. Summation of vertical forces is equal to zero. That means that point M is stable. Therefore, first I'm going to do the summation of horizontal forces. So first I'm going to consider RA. It is acting exactly horizontal. So I will take RA. It is acting in positive direction. Now if I consider that 600 Newton, there is no horizontal component because it is acting exactly in the vertical direction, that is downward. Therefore, there is no horizontal component. If I consider RB, it is acting exactly vertical. There is no horizontal component for RB. The remaining is RC. If I resolve in horizontal direction, angle is given in horizontal direction. Therefore, horizontal component of RC is RC cos 48.18 degree. That is acting like this. Therefore, horizontal component of RC, that is minus RC cos 48.18 degree. I take a minus because it is acting in leftward direction. Therefore, that is minus. So I considered all the forces. Therefore, this is equal to zero. So, but in this case, RC I already calculated. So I can substitute that value. Therefore, RA minus RC is 670.92 cos 48.18 is equal to 0. Therefore, RA is equal to, where RC I calculated in the previous step. Therefore, RA we can calculate, that is 447.36 newton. After doing the summation in horizontal direction, I want to do the summation in vertical direction. So I have one more unknown, that is RB. Now the first force I am going to consider RB. It is acting in vertical direction, RB. So I considered that. Then 600 newton, it is acting in downward direction. I will take it as minus 600. If I consider RA, it is acting exactly in horizontal direction. There is no vertical component. So remaining is RC. If I resolve that in vertical direction, they give an angle in horizontal direction. Therefore, vertical component is sine. Therefore, minus, it is acting downward. If I resolve, it is acting like this, downward. Therefore, minus RC sine 48.18 degree is equal to 0. So I want to calculate RB minus 600. RC we already calculated, that is 670.92 sine 48.18 is equal to 0. If I substitute for RB, or if I solve for RB, we will get 1099.99. So I can take 1100 newton. Here we have our problem number 9. So problem is like this. So two identical rollers weighing 400 newtons are placed in a trench as shown in the figure. Assuming all the contact surfaces are smooth, determine the reactions at contact point A, B, C and D. So first thing I have to note, that is identical roller. They not given any radius in this problem, but they mentioned it as identical roller. So they given two identical rollers of weight 400 newton. So I will take this as P, then this as Q. So first I'm going to draw the free body diagram at Q. So I will consider that point Q. First I'm going to draw always, that is weight of the object, that is 400 newton acting vertically downward. Then I have to check this sphere is contact how many points. So in this sphere it is going to contact D and C. So action towards that supports or that contact point will be like this. Reaction in the opposite direction. So simply I can remember towards the center of the sphere. Reaction is always towards the center of the sphere. So reaction from C, I will take it as RC. I can shift in the line of action. So in this drawing, I can draw here, that is RC. At the same time, from the contact surface D, one reaction is coming, that is RD. I can shift in the line of action. So I can draw in the free body diagram in this direction, that is RD. Now I want the angle. So RC. So if I complete this triangle, so this will be 90 degree, because tangent and radius makes an angle 90 degree. Therefore remaining is 60 degree, because total angle of the triangle is 180 degree. Therefore I can write, or I can take this as 60 degree. Now angle of RD, if I join these centers P and Q, they given, that's why I told identical rollers is very important in this problem. So identical means whatever I joined PQ is parallel to BC. That means PQ makes an angle 30 degree with the horizontal. So if I take the example, if two parallel lines, if one parallel line is makes an angle 30 degree, one more parallel line is also makes an angle 30 degree with the horizontal. So therefore, if they not given radius also, we can solve this problem. That's why they given two rollers are identical. Now I can find other angle. This will be 90 degree, because weight is always acting downward with the horizontal. Vertical line will makes an angle 90 degree. Therefore this is also 90 degree. So this one I can calculate, that is 180 minus 60 minus 30, that will be 90 degree. So after getting all the angle and forces, I can apply Lamy's theorem. So known force, that is 400 Newton, divided by other two forces for 400 Newton, that is RC and RD. If you are not knowing the concept, please check the description. I explained what is Lamy's theorem. I did the derivation also. Please check that video. So 400 Newton, other two forces RC and RD, angle between them, that is 90 degree. So therefore sine 90. This is equal to the next force I'm going to consider, RC. For RC, other two forces are 400 and RD. So angle between them, that is total angle is this one, that is 90 plus 30 is equal to 120 degree. Therefore sine 120 degree. The last force, that is RD, that is here. For RD, other two forces are RC and 400 Newton. Angle between them, that is total angle 90 plus 60, that is 150 degree. Therefore RD divided by sine 150 degree. Now I'm going to consider equation number 1 and equation number 2. So I can calculate RC. RC is equal to 400 into sine 120 divided by sine 90. If I do the calculation, that is 346.41 Newton. So now I'm going to consider equation number 1 and equation number 3. So I can get RD. RD is equal to 400 into sine 150 divided by sine 90. That is 200 Newton. So I completed all the forces from the point Q. Now I'm going to consider point P. So I will take free body diagram at P. So I will take that point P. First, I'm going to draw the weight of that object or sphere, that is 400 Newton. They given in the question vertically downward. Weight is always acting vertically downward. Now I have to check it is going to touch how many points. So first it is going to touch point D, then A and B. That means it is going to develop three reactions point from. So if I see this sphere, the action will be towards the touching point like this. Reaction from D in the opposite direction towards the center of the sphere, that is RD. Reaction from B towards the center of the sphere, that is in this direction, that is RB. Last one, that is A, reaction is towards the center of the sphere, that is RA. So whatever RD I can shift in the line of action, then I can draw here this way, that is RD. Now one more force, that is RB, I can shift in the line of action, then I can draw here, that is RB. Then one more force, that is RA, I can shift in the line of action, then I can shift here, I can write RA. Now we have to find the angle. So RB, if I draw this triangle, this will be 90 degree, therefore remaining is 60 degree. With respect to horizontal, here it will be 60 degree. So one more angle, if I draw like this, this is 30 degree, they already given in the question, two parallel lines, therefore opposite angle this will be 30 degree. Now remaining is vertical and horizontal, always 90 degree. Plane is vertical, therefore reaction in the horizontal direction. So these are the forces, four forces. I can't apply Lamy's theorem. I have to go for the equilibrium condition. So equilibrium condition, horizontal component of the forces, that is summation of horizontal component is equal to zero, summation of vertical component is equal to zero. I'm taking this condition because equilibrium means resultant is zero. So in this case, summation of horizontal forces zero, first condition, that is RA acting in positive direction, plus then 400 Newton, there is no horizontal component because it is acting exactly vertical. If I resolve that RD, the horizontal component will be cos theta because angle is given with respect to horizontal. It is acting in negative direction, therefore RD cos 30. If I resolve that RB, the horizontal component will be cos theta because angle is given, that 60 with the horizontal. Therefore, if I resolve that, horizontal component will be like this. Therefore, I can take minus RB cos 60 is equal to 0. So I will take this as equation number 1. Now I'm going to take second condition, sigma Fy is equal to 0. So RA, I'm going to consider there is no vertical component for RA. 400 Newton acting downward, I will take minus 400. If I resolve that RB in vertical direction, angle is given with respect to horizontal, therefore vertical component will be sine, that is RB sine 60. that is acting upward, therefore it is positive. So I will take plus RB sine 60. Then we have RD, third force. The vertical component of RD, if I resolve that force, it will be acting downward. Angle is given with respect to horizontal, therefore vertical component will be sine, therefore minus RD sine 30 is equal to 0. So we know the value of RD here, that is 200, we calculated in previous step. So I will simplify this equation, that is minus 400 plus RB sine 60 minus 200 sine 30 is equal to 0. So I have to calculate RB is equal to 577.35 newton. So after that, I'm going to substitute these values in equation number 1. So equation number 1 will be here. So RA is unknown, minus RD we already calculated, that is 200 cos 30. RB just now we calculated, that is minus 577.35 cos 60 is equal to 0. So we will get RA value, that is 461.88 newton.